Even though new Omega watches are far more expensive, 500 or even less can still buy you some very interesting vintage models from the 1950s, 60s, and 70s. The fact that these watches can be found for under 500 has little to do to their quality or beauty. The issue with most vintage Omegas or just vintage watches in general is the case sizes. Most people tend to flock over bigger watches and tend to find the 34mm size cases to be a bit small for their taste. But for us guys with smaller or slender wrists, it's an upside because there is more vintage watches available at a cheaper price than the newer and bigger models. Vintage Omegas are the best way to get an entry luxury watch for a great price. However, you should keep in mind that servicing a vintage Omega can cost anywhere from $700 and up. Sometimes you'll find a watch for a lower price, but it will need servicing, which will cost more to get running than what you paid for the watch. The best option would be to buy a service and ready-to-wear watch, which most likely would have a restored or repainted dial to look new again, which is hated by vintage watch collectors. But for someone like me that just wants to wear and enjoy the watch, this would be a great option. Although this is a dress watch, which definitely complements any suit, I don't dress up as much as I would like to, but that doesn't stop me from enjoying these watches. They look absolutely stunning with any button-down shirt, but I mostly wear them casually with just a t-shirt. Keep in mind that rules about fashion and style are yours to make as you see fit. Next up, we have the Sarb 033. As you can see, it has a similar dial as the dressier Omega, but also has a sporty side, making this a very versatile and perfect for any scenario, from casual to formal. The Sarb 033 is a legendary watch. It is widely praised for its classic styling and 38mm size, not to mention the exceptional value for the money. The quality and craftsmanship of the in-house movement is definitely worth it. This is one of those watches that looks far more expensive than what you paid for. Many watch collectors would agree this is a great cheap alternative to the Rolex Explorer. Now, I'm not saying it's equivalent, but it has been argued as a cheaper alternative. The Sarb 033 is also known as the Baby Grand Seiko, which has similar DNA to its expensive brother, the Grand Seiko. It also comes in a white dial, the Sarb 035, but I personally enjoy the black dial. I think I get more wear out of the black dial. The watch has a more of a dressy aesthetic, but the curvature and the polished stainless steel gives off a sporty look, making this watch surprisingly versatile and a true strap monster. Although Seiko stopped producing the Sarb 033 and the Sarb 035 back in 2018, you can still find plenty available online. Anywhere from $300 to $500 on eBay, or even Amazon is still selling them brand new from $370 to $400. The price does fluctuate, but it's still a good deal compared to other places selling them at $500 or more. Last but not least, we have the Hamilton Khaki 38mm Automatic. One of the best two watches you can pick up for under $500 that comes with a Swiss automatic movement. The case on the Hamilton Khaki Automatic is 38mm, but has a 47mm lug to lug, which can be a bit on the larger end for some, but because of the curvature of the case and the 11mm thickness, giving this watch a better fit. In fact, the beauty about this watch is the thickness is about similar to a quartz watch, but packs one of the best and most reliable movement, the Hamilton H10 80 hour reserve, which is a modded ETA 2824-2, also known as the Powermatic 80 movement. The Hamilton Khaki Automatic comes in a finely brushed stainless steel case with a highly polished smooth bezel, with a nice black dial with white Arabic numerals that's surrounded by the 24-hour numerals, which can be used to tell a second time zone or used for military time. This watch pays homage to the military-styled field watches that Hamilton has produced since the 1940s. The khaki field automatic may seem reserved at first glance, but the more I wear it, the more I like it. This watch may not wow you at first, but it's a perfect casual everyday watch that's actually made to handle rough usage. The 38mm Hamilton Khaki comes in both automatic and mechanical. The automatic has an 80 hour reserve compared to the mechanical version that has a 30 hour reserve. Technically, they're the same movement, only the H10 was modded from 8 beats per second to 6 beats per second. So the automatic is 2 beats per second slower, but has an additional 50 hour reserve. There you have it guys, that's my pick on the top 3 best watches under $500. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that thumbs up, it really helps out this channel. Other than that, I'll see you next time.